This is Jeff Bezos. He is the richest person in the world. Back in 2017, he became the world's first centibillionaire. That's a net worth of $100 billion. And having made tens of billions during the coronavirus pandemic, that figure's now a whole lot more.
How's that even possible?
His fortune came from founding Amazon, which he's still the boss of. That's not to mention his other ventures, from the Washington Post to Amazon-owned Whole Foods to space exploration company Blue Origin. The list goes on. But Mr. Bezos seems a bit of a contradictory character. A nerdy alpha male with a reputation for really caring for customers, but accused of neglecting his employees. A businessman criticized for his charity efforts, but fixated on saving the planet. Like his Silicon Valley counterpart, Elon Musk, Bezos sees investing in space travel as a moral duty.
Mr. Bezos.
But back on Earth, with politicians coming at him from all sides.
Get off of welfare.
As a society, are we willing to accept the cost?
And one of his own vice presidents quitting over Amazon's response to pandemic-concerned workers. He seems to have his hands full. Here's a few things you should know about Jeff Bezos. At just 3 years old, Bezos figured out how to take apart his cot with a screwdriver because he wanted it to be like a real bed. He developed engineering skills at a very young age, setting up an electronic alarm to keep his younger siblings out of his room. Age 10, his precociousness got the better of him when he caused his grandmother to burst into tears after calculating how many years she'd taken off her life by smoking. His grandfather took him aside and told him,
"He said you're going to figure out one day that it's harder to be kind than clever."
Bezos' public image is arguably someone who cares more about cleverness than kindness, and it's his ongoing focus on metrics at Amazon that really shows this. Early on, the Amazon boss would ask interviewees for test scores and continually raise the score required for the job. As the Amazon talent pool increased, those with the lowest scores were let go. In Amazon warehouses, workers have complained of timed toilet breaks and electronic workstations which monitor employees to ensure they are packing enough boxes. But Bezos' affection for metrics might actually explain Amazon's highly unusual way of doing business. For years, the CEO got a lot of grief from Wall Street for the store's lack of profit.
As the stock price was going the wrong way, everything inside the company was going the right way.
But who was the tortoise, not the hare? Mr. Bezos was not going to be rushed, and was happy to bide his time reinvesting and expanding the company, confident his long-term vision would pay off.
Many of the traits that make Amazon unusual are now deeply ingrained in the culture.
Bezos has always done things a little bit differently at Amazon. He set up the bookstore in his garage in 1994, warning early investors there was a 70% chance it would fail. Since then, he's established many rules, rituals, and traditions, which to the outsider may seem a touch eccentric. Don't even think of using PowerPoint in an Amazon presentation. It's banned. Instead, everyone reads and discusses a long, carefully written memo. He doesn't like big teams either. In fact, according to Bezos, any one team should be small enough that it can be fed by two pizzas.
If there's one thing Amazon.com is about, it's obsessive attention to the customer experience.
Above all, Bezos likes to talk about what he calls customer obsession. In fact, if you have a problem with Amazon, you can even send Jeff an email.
My email address is famous, and I keep it, and then I read it. It's jeff@amazon.com.
Mr. Bezos will often forward a complaint to a colleague, accompanied by a single question mark, meaning they should probably drop whatever they're doing and look into this. In the office, employees are encouraged to rate each other and expected to adhere to the 14 leadership principles, which include having the backbone to criticize others. When a New York Times article depicted an atmosphere of bullying at the company, Jeff Bezos responded directly in a memo to his employees.
"Anyone working in a company that really is like the one described in the New York Times would be crazy to stay."
In 2018, President Trump accused Bezos of sales tax avoidance and anti-competitive business practices, leading to Amazon's share price falling by 9% and reducing Bezos' personal wealth by over $10 billion, although he later recouped this. Criticism of Amazon continued with Senator Bernie Sanders' Stop Bezos Act.
"The wealthiest person in the world is advertising jobs that pay workers wages that are so low that they have to go on food stamps."
But Bezos actually responded and raised the minimum wage at Amazon to $15.
"Mr. Bezos and Amazon are now leading the way."
And this isn't the only time Bezos has made a dramatic U-turn. In 2018, he rebuffed criticism for a perceived lack of charity work by contributing a total of $2 billion through his Bezos Day One Fund for Homelessness and Education, a charity founded by his ex-wife, author Mackenzie Bezos.
We are really evolved to be pioneers.
Bezos invests $1 billion each year into his space company, Blue Origin.
This is the most important work I'm doing.
When I was 5 years old, Neil Armstrong stepped onto the moon. I was imprinted with this passion for space and for exploration.
Since even high school, Bezos has dreamt of an epic plan for humanity.
This gem of a planet, we're finally, as a species, big enough to really impact it. We can fix that problem by moving out into the solar system.
Like fellow magnate Elon Musk, he's creating a fleet of rockets which, as if by magic, can land themselves vertically, making them reusable and so far more financially viable. Unlike Musk, he isn't speeding towards his goal, but methodically and quietly plotting it out. Predatum ferociter, step by step ferociously, is the motto of Blue Origin, and one which Bezos himself lives by, who today is building a 10,000-year clock deep inside a mountain on his Texas ranch as a symbol of long-sightedness. This incremental and often secretive approach was how Bezos conquered retail. And it could be how he conquered space, too.